Today, BP has started its latest attempt to control the oil that continues to gush into the Gulf of Mexico. For 6 weeks now, we've been watching this, creating the worst oil disaster in our country's history. The so-called cut and cap process involves cutting the leaking pipe just above the blowout preventer, which would temporarily increase the flow of oil. Then, a small containment cap will be placed over the pipe in hopes of siphoning the leaking oil to a ship on the surface. Meantime, in the next several minutes, President Obama will hold his first meeting with a co-chairman of an independent commission investigating the oil leak. Those co-chairs, former Florida Governor and U.S. Senator Bob Graham and former EPA head William Riley. After that meeting, the president will talk with reporters. We'll bring you that live right here on MSNBC. That's happening about 12:15 p.m. Eastern time. Also today, Attorney General Eric Holder is visiting the Gulf Coast to meet with federal prosecutors and the attorneys general of Louisiana, Mississippi, and Alabama. They'll talk about what legal action might be taken against BP. In the meantime, Brian Williams, anchor and managing editor of NBC Nightly News, will broadcast live tonight from Venice, Louisiana. And Brian's on the phone with us now. Brian, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure, Tamara.
You were there May 3rd, the beginning of this disaster. Give us an assessment of what it was like then and what you've seen now.
It's been Groundhog Day for these folks ever since. For us, we're back in Plaquemines Parish, and of course, the situation has changed dramatically, and we may see another change this week. The winds could bring more of this oil up along Mississippi, Alabama. Yesterday, they extended the fishing ban in anticipation of that. And, you know, everyone here is in suspended animation. People are angry. A few of them are resigned that this, you know, the oil is here. What the rest of the country may not understand is this has removed people's ability to make a living. This threatens an entire culture. As James Carville is fond of pointing out, this isn't like other parts of the United States. Southern Louisiana is different, and that's what's being threatened here.
It's interesting, Brian. I was in New Orleans over the weekend, and so many people were linking BP with President Obama, not giving much separation between the two. What are you hearing there as far as federal responsibility from those fishermen and the folks who live there?
Well, Tamron, you're absolutely right. And here, this is what the White House was fearing. The White House mantra was, if we touch it, we own it. The problem with that was it got to be too long, and the president had to step up, as you and I covered last week, taking responsibility for fixing this. Well, he's touched it now. People are angry. There is no question that most of the anger is correctly targeted at BP. Nevertheless, had the president not gone near this at all, it would probably be worse as a PR matter for the White House. But these are ugly days. A glance at the front page of USA Today just shows how many problems we're all dealing with simultaneously. And this is, as you know, if you were down here this weekend, it's a grim mood because this place can ill afford another crisis 5 years following the one that almost made it tough to come back.
And on Nightly News over the weekend, the president of Plaquemines Parish, where you are, he really seemed unimpressed with the number of people coming down to clean up. I believe the number's around 20,000, saying that, yeah, it's great that BP is doing something, but they don't seem very impressed with the efforts at all there.
Well, that's right, because Billy Nungesser and others can still, it's still possible to get in a fan boat and go find a stretch of shoreline or a cove, a piece of marshland where it's been untouched by human hands. You've got oil lopping up, coming up and down with the tide. That's why those cane, the kind of reeds are coated with the oil going up a foot and a half. And it's dead. It's just declare it dead wherever the oil has touched, because the ecosystem is cooked after this gets in there. So you can, you know, when you get down here, you can sense the frustration and you sure can understand it.
All right, Brian Williams, thank you so much, Brian, for making time to join us this hour. And a reminder, special coverage of the Gulf of Mexico oil disaster tonight on NBC Nightly News with Brian Williams live from the Gulf Coast. Thank you, Brian.
Thanks, Tamara.
Absolutely. Well, much